morning class. Today we're going to talk about ethical ownership, okay? So I'm just going to go through a brief example of learning objectives. So I'm going to introduce the topic of followership. I'm going to give you a definition of what ethical followership is. I'm going to discuss the three types of ethical followership, which are conformists, dramaturgicals, and the resistant follower. I want to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of each of these, and these are going to contribute to it. And we're going to talk about the understanding of the different examples that we go through. Now, we're going to welcome a guest lecturer today. She's a specialist in ethical followership. Her name is Lauren Markey. Now, I just want to let you know she's a bit of a moony one, okay? So, she's going to come in just now, so she's... Yeah, come on in.
Hi, girls. Good morning.
This is Lauren Markey. She is a specialist in the topic we will be doing today. Good morning, Lauren.
My name is Lauren Markey, and I'm a lecturer at King's University, and I specialise in a topic called ethical followership. Dr. McGovern has told me that you've done some research on this topic, so I hope you have some knowledge of it.
Okay, so just an introduction into what exactly is followership. So contemporary followership is the focus on the extent to which followers create, construct, or participate in the leadership of others. Followership is the ability to follow others and to take direction well. So now Lauren will just discuss followership in more detail.
So ethical followership is a little bit more detailed than just regular followership. So ethical followership are followers who are independent, effective, and positive thinkers who fully evaluate and understand the leader's actions and decisions before accepting them. Does anybody know any more information about ethical followership? Yes? What's your name?
Anya.
Go ahead.
Well, what I found from it was like, it's not usually the follower that acts unethically, it's usually the leader that asks the follower to like do an unethical request, and the leader expects them to just do it. But how the follower actually responds to this depends on like their beliefs. Like some have weak beliefs, and like some tend to follow the traditional like definition of followership, whereas those with like stronger beliefs tend to like actually ask questions about like why this decision over another decision, and so on.
Yeah, that's really good research. Well done. I'm going to tell you some extra points about ethical followership. So an ethical follower must always understand the reasons behind the decision and must ask why the decision. An ethical follower should back the decision of their leader, but only after they understand the decision and believe it is ethical. For ethical followership to occur in a workplace, there needs to be a responsible leader who reinforces and promotes ethical behaviour. Leaders must also be prepared for their followers to ask why to those certain decisions. So ethical followership is all about asking questions and why it should be ethical. Does anybody else know any other topics about ethical followership? There's different types. Does anybody know any?
Anything? Robin, yeah, you can answer that.
I read Collinson's article, and that tells us that there's three types of followership. There's the conformist, the resistant, and the dramaturgical.
Robin, would you be able to tell me about the conformist follower?
The conformist follower is a follower who doesn't want any conflict or any trouble with anybody. They will just do anything to kind of avoid any conflict.
Yeah.
It can be dangerous because if the leader wants them to do something that could lead to a hazard or something, they will go ahead and do it because they just don't want any conflict. They say yes to most things, and they're just really, yeah, they'll do anything just when it's just no conflict.
Yeah, the conformist is really a yes person who says yes to everything that their follower wants them to do. Sometimes it can make them a little bit unethical because they're just afraid of saying no. And does anybody know any advantages or disadvantages? I already gave you a few, but can anybody elaborate on that?
Sorry, if you wouldn't mind me interrupting, I actually did a bit of my own research on the
advantages. Yeah, of course, go ahead.
So, like, I could just stand this all over. Okay. So the first advantage I found with the conformist was that they are the perfect follower. Many studies on followership promote the conformist as the perfect follower. It has been suggested that the conformist holds the qualities of the perfect role model in followership. These qualities include integrity, honesty, and credibility. Another advantage I found was that conformists view themselves as valuable assets. So they have a tendency to be preoccupied with themselves as valued objects in the eyes of those in authority. On one hand, whilst the attentive worker is a good example of an obedient identity, a more contemporary example is the ambitious knowledge worker. Okay? So then the third advantage I found was a successful career. So having a successful career is seen to be something of great importance of the eyes of a conformist self. Gray emphasizes the importance of preoccupations which are expressed in careerism, and he informs us of how constructing your identity and protecting it are often held to be of great concern to employees and managers alike. So that's the advantages, sorry, Lauren, that I found.
Yeah, that's great.
And then some of the disadvantages I found with the conformist was, the first I found was the negative impact of having a successful career. So for conformists, having a successful career can result in increased pressure due to working longer hours, being away from their families, having to meet strict deadlines, and having to travel on a regular basis, okay? So all of these factors could in turn lead to the breakdown of marriages because, you know, the husband or the wife's out working longer hours, and increased stress levels just because of the longer days and the workload that they have, you know? So then the last disadvantage I found was that they tend to distance themselves from the organization and their work in some circumstances. So an alternative conformist who sees little opportunity for personal development will try and distance themselves from the organization they are involved in and escape from their work into their own private little world. So employees could distance themselves from the organization using several strategies, such as absenteeism and resignation. Okay, that means, you know, when they quit. So employees begin to try and build a psychological wall between their private and public selves, which in turn can result in markets deteriorating and companies announcing job losses. Okay, so that's just some of the disadvantages I found. Now girls, I'll have these slides up after class, and you know, I want you to take some notes or whatever. So yeah, that's what I have, Lauren. Sorry about that.
Good. Do you just want to take over or let you come? So the type two is a dramaturgical follower. Does anybody have any info on this?
Go ahead. I think dramaturgy is kind of like a sociological perspective commonly used in microsociological.
Yeah, go ahead.
That accounts for social interaction in everyday life, but it's kind of like known as a charismatic relationship.
Yeah. Well done, Leah. That was really good research. Just a few other points on a dramaturgical follower. So for Goffman, the subject matter of dramaturgical sociology is the creation, maintenance, and destruction of common understanding of reality by people working individually and collectively to present a shared and unified image of that reality. Dramaturgical analysis is the idea that people's day-to-day lives can be understood and resembling performers in action on a theatre stage. As we present ourselves in various situations, we are much like actors, putting on performances for their audience. Our life, according to Goffman, is a series of performances. So, does anybody know if there's any advantages or disadvantages towards this follower?
Yeah,
No? Okay, I'll go ahead. If you know any, jump in. So the advantages to the dramaturgical follower. In regard to impression management, employees disclosing, exaggerating, or omitting information in the workplace may work in their favour. Impression management is seen as a necessary tool in areas of negotiation and career strategies. Employees exhibit dramaturgical followership are consistently aware of their image and their quantifiable performance measures in the workplace make employees comparable with each other. Due to the heightened self-consciousness of the dramaturgical self, this sense of competition and the need for image preservation may be an incentive for motivation. Increased awareness in the workplace may lead to increased awareness regarding the job at hand and the business environment. More adaptable to a job role. So there are the advantages. Does anybody know any disadvantages?
Robin, I can see you looking there. I think you want to say something here.
Employees are usually preoccupied with their self-image, which may result in like a loss of identity because they're trying to be more like, they're trying to fit in too hard.
Yeah. And one last disadvantage is the pursuit of achieving personal goals may take precedence over achieving the organization's strategic goal. So that follower kind of thinks about themselves more than. So this is the final follower, which is the resistant follower. Does anybody know the definition of this one? Yeah?
This type of followership is a way for the follower to show their dissatisfaction in the organization. It is also a way for them to construct other, more positive identities different to those that are recommended by the organization. Power inevitably causes the production of resistance. This is a way in which followers can protect themselves. Self-protection is a motivator for the resistant follower.
Yeah, that's a really good definition. Some extra points on that side of the follower is there are ways for followers to express their dissatisfaction with the organization. They have self-protection as a motivator. They seek to oppose and resist those who are in higher positions than themselves. An example is whistleblowers. This form of resistance can help adverse effects on the follower's career and may even result in the follower losing their job. Industrial action is a viable form of resistance. And introduction of new technologies that monitor employees and stricter disciplinary practices cause a persistence of resistance. Less obvious forms of resistance and difference are sabotage and irony. So does anybody know any advantages or disadvantages of this follower?
I know some disadvantages.
Yeah, go ahead.
They're usually dominated frequently to their subordinates.
Yeah.
There's limited possibilities for those who engage in resistance. And it creates inequality.
So there are basically all the disadvantages of that type of follower. And then the advantages are workers can deny any involvement or responsibilities when it comes to the running of the organisation. So resistance, true distance. Has a limited effectiveness as a means of dissent, resent, true distance. Resistance, true persistence has an advance of gaining knowledge through trade unions by pushing for answers and knowledge. So these are all the advantages and disadvantages of the resistant follower. So now we're going to go to the games room to play a few games to look at the ethical followers. Right guys, let's go! So from looking at all the different examples of ethical followers, we're going to use students from the class to demonstrate different situations of followers. We'll play a few games and hope to clearly show the different types of followers. The first game we're going to play is Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Can I have 3 volunteers? You 3. So here are some scenarios that you're going to read, and then each one of you are going to pick which one it is.
Hi Anya, would you be able to do some paperwork for me? I'm up to my eyes at meetings and these reports really need to be done.
Oh, I already have a lot of work to do myself. If I get around to it, I'll try and get it done.
So from this scenario, we can see that Anya really doesn't want to complete her leader's work. She knows her leader is going out with her friends for a few hours and getting paid to do that. Anya would like to inform someone about her actions, but she knows her leader will treat her unfavorably. Anya doesn't complete the reports and informs her leader that she had too much work to do. So what type of follower is this?
Am I able to phone a friend, please?
Yeah, of course.
Can I phone Veronica?
Yeah.
Hello?
Hi Grania, it's Lauren here. I are playing Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Lee is having a bit of trouble guessing the answer. Could you help her out?
Hi Anya, would you be able to do some paperwork for me? I'm up to my eyes with meetings and these reports really need to be done.
I already have a lot of work to do myself. If I get around to it, I'll try and get it done.
Anya does not want to complete her leader's work as she knows her leader is going out for a few hours to meet up with friends and getting paid for doing that. Anya would like to inform someone that her actions of her leader, but she knows her leader would treat her unfavourably. Anya doesn't complete the reports and informs her leader that she has too much work to do. Which type of follower is this? A conformist, a resistant, or a dramaturgical follower?
It's a resistant type follower.
Ian, would you like to use this answer?
Yeah, please.
That's correct. So now we're going to play Are You Smarter Than a 10-Year-Old? Can you swap positions so we're ready for our scenario? She thinks it is, and while we're listening to the scenario, Anya's going to have headphones on so she can't hear the answer. Go ahead, girls.
Hi, Robin. We've been issuing fake checks to our clients in order to save money and gain higher profits. Do you mind ringing the bank and informing them that the money has gone through on our end and that it is an issue on their end? If they have any queries, can you do up some fake accounts to show the money coming out of your account, our account?
Sure, Leah. I'll go on to the bank immediately.
Anya, can you put your headphones on when we hear from our 10-year-old?
I think it's a conformist.
Anya, you can take your headphones off. Do you know what type of follower it was?
I'm pretty sure it's a conformist follower.
We're going to cut to the clip of our 10-year-old and find out the correct answer.
I think it's a conformist.
Correct, that's the right answer. So now we're going to play the chase. Robin, you have to guess what type of follower this is, and you only have two chances. You start off with €10,000, and if you get it wrong, you get lowered down to €5,000. Are you ready? Yep. Go ahead.
Hi, Anya. Would you be able to complete a stock feedback and minus report for me?
I have a lot of work to do myself, but if I get my work done, I'll try again. That's
great.
Please let me know if you want.
Girls, come on. Ready? Anya completes her own work and moves on to her manager's work. She has a clear path of what she has to do, complete her own work first, and then her manager's. Robin, do you know which type of follower this is?
Is it a dramaturgical leader?
You're going to lose €5,000 for that one. You have one more chance.
It's definitely a conformist leader.
Correct. You leave with €5,000. That's the end of the game now, girls. Thanks for volunteering. You can go back to your seats. Give them a round of applause. So that concludes today's lecture on ethical followership. Thanks so much for doing all your research. It was really beneficial to yourselves and myself. Does anybody have any questions before we finish up? Yeah.
So, Miss Markey, what type of follower would you consider yourself? Or is that a bit too personal?
I mean, now, you don't need to be asking Miss Markey any personal questions like that, do we now?
Alright.
Next question?
Yeah. You mentioned at the start of the lecture that the conformist follower could be dangerous. I would consider myself a conformist follower because I don't like conflict or situations with conflict. How would this be dangerous?
The conformist follower has detrimental consequences if it's dealt with in the wrong way. Has anybody ever heard of the Nazi Germany case?
Is that when the 6 million Jews were executed?
Yeah, exactly.
So would Hitler have been the leader and then the people that were involved in the detrimental consequences, would they have been the conformist followers?
Yeah, exactly. So Hitler influenced his followers to engage in concentration camps, which led to the detrimental consequences of the Jews being killed.
Okay, so would anyone mind expanding on what Robin has just said there and explain to me the 5 main follower motivations as to why a conformist behaves the way that they do? So any volunteers? Yeah, Grania, go ahead there. Could you just first of all list out the five main follower motivations, and then, you know, just what Robin has just said, and then expand on it and explain to me, Alvin, please. Thanks.
The five main follower motivations are position-based motivation, calculated-based motivation, safety-based motivation, meaning-based motivation, and identity-based motivation. Position-based motivation is when the follower admires the formal position of the leader in the organisation. It is most likely that they look up to the leader and hope to be in their position one day. The calculated motivation, this is when the follower believes that they are following a certain type of leader or leadership style that will help them achieve their goals. This could be by staying on the leader's good side or learning skills beneficial by following that leader, or maybe even seeking advice from the leader. Safety-based motivation, this is when the follower depends on the leader for security. This follower does whatever is necessary in order to have a secure job position. They may fear that if they do not carry out the orders asked by the leader, they may lose their job. Meaning-based motivation, this is the type of motivation when the follower fears conflict, chaos or disagreement in the workplace, and the follower looks to their leader to provide structure or meaning. Identity-based motivation, this is usually conformist followers, they see the leader as powerful, attractive, successful and well known in order to improve their own personal self-esteem.
Okay, that's perfect. Thanks for that, Grania.
Is that it? Does anybody else have any questions? No? Okay, well, I would like to thank, first of all, Miss Markey for coming along to talk to our class today about ethical followership. I'll be handing out, the presentation. I'll print it off and hand it out to you. I'll want you to go home then and write up a project on what you guys have heard today. And so again, can we get a round of applause for Miss Markey?
Thank you all for being here, Miss Markey.
Thank you, bye. So right now, I just have printed off some slides from the presentation today. Thank you, so I'll just hand them all out to you now. And you know what, girls? She really wasn't that bad after all, was she?
No.
Right, anyway, I'll let you off for your lunch break now. I know it's coming up on 1:45. So thank you, and I'll see you in a while.
Right, here we go.
Yeah, I'm getting the bus. Bye.
See you now.
Bye, my father. Thank you.
Just keep walking.